Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today, let's start a series called like the Is It Worth It series. Let me know if you have a better name for this series, but the point of the series is to go through all these plugins and really ask, do you need it? Do you want it? Is it really that cool? So in the past video about native instruments, I went through the instruments I actually use, the plugins I actually use, to give you my honest opinion about should you spend $1,000 on the complete ultimate. And in my opinion, you know, again, I told you, you're either going to make the decision or not, but I showed you the stuff I use. So instead of considering, some people might consider that bashing. So I'll show you today how I actually use Kontakt and how to actually get results from Kontakt. Now I'm using Kontakt 5, which was in Complete 10 Ultimate, which is I think the one I have. So instead of just describing stuff, let's actually build something. So give me a like for this series if you like the series and want to see more about it. Also, let me know which libraries inside of Kontakt you want me to cover, whether that's a third-party company or the stuff that comes in the Native Instruments bundle. But again, you just have to remember, like, when you're using plugins and building and giving these software companies millions and millions of dollars, when have they ever given back to the producer community? And I mean jobs. When have they ever offered jobs? Not just giveaways and like free stuff, but when have they actually given jobs, opportunities, good looks to people? When have they actually given people affiliate codes? Okay, so that's the stuff you really have to ask, because these companies are just taking all this money from our producer community. And what are they doing to uplift us? Not much. Okay, so they do make tutorials. I will give them that. But, you know, we need more as far as a producer community. So that's why even at BusyWorksBeats.com/VintageFire, we're made by producers for producers. So this is not some random person in Germany making you stuff. So without the subtle subconscious bashing, let's go down to Scarby Mark 1 and load up some presets here. And this is like an E-piano sound. And I think the preset, if you click the right arrow, I like that phasey sound. So let's play some chords here at like 93 BPM. I tried this video before, but then the computer froze, trying to load up some Native Instruments sounds. I don't know what the link was. It could be my hard drive, but anyway. I'm going to play D minor 9 into D major 9. Then to F major 9. And then to a chord that is an inversion chord. I would have to like map it out to really give you the name of it, which is my favorite chord, this one. Then back to D minor 9. And then we're gonna play in passing chord. And then back to either C major 9 or D minor 9. So anyway, you can learn the music theory in ease at BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory. But I'm not trying to confuse you with that language. Let's just record. We're gonna have loop record on. Let's do that one more time. Okay, so that's the chord progression. So it's the chords sound good. The instrument can change, but the chords are what makes that sound good. So I like this as a kind of core sound. Let's crank it up a little bit. It's okay. So that will be our chord progression. Now let's get into like the drums. And here's what messed up the thing before, so I don't know if I should do it or not again, but let's just try it anyway. Let's go to the browser and let's add that chord progression into the playlist. Let's go to song mode. Let's go to the browser now. Go to Native Instruments sounds. Now, I did say in the last video that I do like and respect the Native Instruments drum sounds. They have really good drum sounds. And a lot of people go, for example, they go to the Battery 4 library and they go to samples, they go to drums, and they take these like a clap like this. They'll edit it, mix it, and then throw it in the drum kit. So that's where people are grabbing these core samples from. And then they're editing them to make them sound different. Okay, so they're right from the Battery 4 factory library. So let's go to kicks. And instead of actually, let's go to the machine libraries because I like those a little bit more because they're more focused. Let's go to Conant Gardens. Let's go to samples, drums, kicks. And let me start with a clap. I'm going for like a Jay Dilla-esque sound. I think the Conant Gardens was inspired by that sound, or I think it's Detroit. I forget which one, but it's definitely Detroit, I think. Let's add this into the playlist. Let's add a snap in here. And you just gotta be careful with FL, I guess with hard drives in general. If it's reading too much information back and forth, it can like freeze up sometimes. That's what happened in the last video. So I'm delaying the snap a little bit with time shift. So the snap's just after the clap. And let's find a hi-hat. Now here's where the system froze up a little bit. Right click. Now here's where the groove's gonna come in. So I'm just gonna go 1, 2, 1, 2. Right click, fill each two steps. Now sounds super computerized. Let's normalize this for you. Now here's how you make it sound cool. You go to your wrench tool, turn up time shift. So I want the hi-hat just after the clap. Now I'll show you a trick with the kick. Grab a kick. We just have to find a kick that can do ba-boom. So again, you may be like, oh, these drums are weak, but that's because you don't know how to mix. So don't think just because the drums have a lower dB or whatever that they're not good drums. Let's use this one just for example. Right click, open that up. So I'm gonna go boom. So I'll try and think Jay Dilla-esque. First thing I'm gonna do is turn up the swing parameter. Wait, boom, ch-ch-ba-boom, ch-ch-ch-boom. Okay, let's go to the graph editor. And again, this is a company that is so giving to the hip hop community, so to speak, but like when, like who have you ever seen that's actually benefiting in the producer community from this company though? That's the one thing I will just constantly bring up because they're kind of like giving us hip hop sounds, but like where are the opportunities and stuff? So anyway, go to your graph editor, go to velocity, turn down your velocity for the kicks that come before the other kick. I'm gonna clone this because I came up with a different pattern. I'm gonna get rid of one kick and let's do pattern 3, pattern 2 for the kicks. Now I usually don't put the hi-hats on the same track, but now here's the trick. Go to your kick, turn up your time shift. Make sure you're cutting itself. Now is this the perfect kick for the vibe? Not necessarily. Let's see if we can find a different one. Now, usually speaking, they'll do two different kicks. So for example, instead of the ghost note, they'll switch it to a different kick that's lighter. But the only thing with this is you have to get the timing right, which is complicated. So let's just not make it complex for no reason and do what we had before. I'll show you how to pump up your kick. This kick doesn't have that much character, but you can go to Fruity Soft Clipper for your kick track, turn up your threshold, pull down your fader. Okay, go back to your kick, go to your wrench tool, turn up your volume multiplier. Then you can can go to your envelope under volume and shorten the kick out with the hold parameter. Just to make it a little bit shorter. So that's how you get that punchy sound. So don't give up on the sounds just because they initially sound a little weak. So the trick is using time shift with your kick. Baseline, let's go to contact again. And again, let's go to, well, not again, but I mentioned this before, Scarby pre-bass. I used to use J-bass a lot, but I think pre-bass might be a little bit more precise. Now, let's just use the regular, not the amped one. So I used to double this up as like a guitar. There aren't really that many good guitar plugins. Just being honest, that's the one thing that will never be, well, not, I don't want to say never, but hasn't been recreated too well. But bass has been. Is record in higher octaves and then transpose it down. One of the two of the notes are, I played the wrong note. I think it was this note right here. Yeah, sweet. Where was it? Fix these two notes here. This should be B. Then I hit control down twice or once. Might be too low. Let's pull it up. Now I can't think of any like amp I would throw up the guitar rig. Let's use all the native instrument stuff. So the guitar rig, left and right inputs, very important to create the stereo sound. And let's go to amps and let's see what they have. Actually, let's go to presets just to keep it simple because I want to do bass presets. Let's just click on the bass presets because they already have it figured out. Oh, let's turn this way down. Wide for me. Too clean. I'm trying to decide on the octave of bass I want. I don't really like this octave. Might just be better for this tone because it really wasn't for bass. So let's run it through some guitar effects and then we'll do a different bass. Let's do guitar, let's do styles, and let's say this is funk and soul. I do like that they have a lot of presets in here as well. Let's do funk lead. Now you got to be careful with the volume. bass guitar like it were an electric, which is how I used it. Clone this. Well, almost replaced it. Clone. And then let's play a bass line instead of. So boom, boom. It's just hard for me to hear bass sometimes. Bass octave of me. Picked up the bass and he was like boom, he just played that one bass note and people were like, yo, that bass line is complex, it's crazy. It was funny, he was using the machine. So I'm just gonna record notes in automation, play one note, one. Oh, how do we get that off beat? So you have to swing with the bass the same way you swing with the kick. Keep in mind the swing applies automatically to the tracks in FL. Once you turn it on, you can turn it off by clicking here, going to your cog icon, and then going to the wrench icon and turning off your swing for that thing. So if you record in swing, you could turn the extra swing off, or if you, and vice versa. See what it sounds like with added swing. Super simple bass line, like nothing going on. Let's open up Guitar Rig. Let's go to bass amps again. Let's get a clean bass. Clean bass is probably all we need. We don't need anything crazy. Let's pull it down in volume. Level this track a little bit. I'm trying to think of more instruments we could use. So at this point, I would add more synth stuff. But since I don't, let's use FM8 for some synths. I said this is contact, right? So let's see what they have in contact. And let's just go through. So I'm looking for like older synths. I think there's a retro synths library here. Retro machines. Let's see what they have here. Super JP. Let's see what's in here. Bass, brass, lead, pad. Let's try pad. All I'm going to do here is copy the chord progression for this sound. I like that pad sound so far. I didn't listen to it all the way through, but let's paste that. Synthesized strings, which usually sound good all the time. Let's just turn it down in volume. Only thing is I have to drag out the notes so they don't have those pauses. And the way I would do that here is manually highlight everything, hit Alt, left click, and just drag it out. You have to be careful with FL because it will create overlapping notes. So for those, I will highlight that as a whole, hit Alt, L, and then only with selection. That way, it will fill in the gaps. Now, technically, you could do this for everything, but I would be careful because it could overlap into different chords, blah, blah, blah. But just want to make sure we're not overlapping notes. See how it stretches this D note all the way out? I don't want that. Just want to manually go in, fix that. I don't know why FL cuts off the note. Boggles my mind, but. See how it sounds like when we're cut off here? It's probably because something was overlapping. Could be velocity too. Now we have that Pharrell-esque sound. Came up with another drum pattern in my head. Boom, 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 ch. Doom, doom, ch. Let's find it. Also, I want to add a little reverb. Let's add fruity reverb. Actually, let's use their reverb. RC, what is it? RC48 is the bigger reverb, I think. Hall reverb. Let's go to mix level so we can mix and blend them together. A little pre-delay. Let me solo this. And I want to give it a nice delay, decay. Let's find the decay knob here. I think you have to manually use these knobs. I think, 1 second, yeah. Mids, okay. Blend two so that it's not all reverb. Normalize it, send it through track 9, run it through the soft clipper, threshold all the way up, fader down, go back to your snare, just crank up levels. Now on this one I'm going to go to a new pattern because I don't feel like editing each pattern of the drums, so let's just add in a snares side stick. Yeah, that adds a little more, add time shift. And just crank it. I'd use the hold parameter again to shorten out the tail because it's a little bit lengthy. We can add. Let's do contact again. And now the meme going around is if you hit the wrong contact library and it takes so long to load, you can't like exit or anything. That's funny because that happened when we used to use hard disk drives, which are the slower loading hard drives. So I would suggest SSD for this type of stuff, but it's pricey. So doesn't, you know, I understand. That's why I'm trying to help you invest a little bit more strategically in the beginning so you don't spend like a grip on this complete and then you don't have the hard drive to even use this stuff. Okay, where are we at? Forgot what I was doing. Okay, Retro Synths, Retro Machines, excuse me. And let's see what else they have. So, not familiar with these names, but let's go to Analog Machines and that sound. I mean, I like the core sound, but let's try something else. You can also layer, so let's layer. So what you do is double click on another sound and then make your MIDI channel A1. And I think they've added, so this is a one thing I didn't like about this controller, the Complete Control S61, at least the version I have. I bought two, but they have that digital pitch wheel and it just, you can't do R&B pitch slides the same way with a digital pitch wheel. It's just not the same. So they've added the pitch wheel, a physical pitch wheel back, I believe, which was super important to do. But Certain pitch wheels just do pitch bending way better. The Moog's pitch wheel is the best pitch wheel I've ever used in my entire life. Next to the Cord Chronos pitch wheel, it's just, you can't match those pitch wheels, in my opinion. And I think the Prophet 6 pitch wheel is okay, but the Moog is the best pitch wheel I've ever had. So let's see what we can stack. Layer some sounds here. Warm tube sounds weird, but let's try it. Stacking all this stuff. Also, I'm looking for a legato function, so let me figure out. I don't use this plugin, so let me see where it would be. Legato. Do that for each one. Or let's do solo. Poly right now. There we go. So I'm just going to improv some lead lines. I'm not going to obsess over this. Let me just see where we start in the song. Start on D instead. Okay, so I'll just fiddle around for a while. And I always mess up, so let me just. Okay, I've changed up my idea. So I had the pitch wheel going, but we could barely hear it, so I'm not gonna obsess over this. Add some effects to it so it's not super upfront. And let's keep with their effects. So I think their effect, which I don't have on here, is called like delay something. I don't think I have it on here. Or no, it's called like echo. What is it called? what is their delay called? I forget. So let's just use Guitar Rig because I can't remember their delay name, unfortunately. Doesn't stand out. Let's do component. And let's go to delay and echo. Let's try psych delay anyway. I like this one. Down arrow, sync the delay times. Set the time to something normal like 1/4. Where's that one? Pitch it down. Add reverb. Ring reverb. There's a lot going on, so let me pull the lead synth to the right. Thank you. clipping. I didn't realize. So let's turn everything down. And as far as mastering, I don't use their stuff to master. I don't even know if they have a limiter. I'm really thinking in my head, did they have a limiter? Can't say they do or don't. I don't know. I haven't gone in there mixing. I don't even think they have a mixing suite per se, but where is our EQ? Passive EQ, where you at, buddy? Where you at, buddy? Also, there's something like solid EQ. I don't use these, so like it's not popping out in my brain, so I have to manually go through each one. Here we go. Solid bus compressor, solid EQ. Let's use this. Use a solid EQ just for general EQ. Nothing crazy here. Boost at about 100. And I want it to be a bell curve. I really like that. It reminds me of a Poltech. Now I'm boosting it 6.8 dB, but adds that punch that we need. Technically, I should be doing this on the kick track, but I'm being lazy here. We're missing some of the mids somewhere, like widen the band a little bit. That's a leveling thing. Again, this is not proper mastering by any means, because I should be leveling and doing this to individual tracks, but I'm not. I really can't think of their limiter option. It's really slipping my mind, which is not a good thing when you're trying to mix and you can't remember the plugin. So let's go to dynamics, assuming this is going to be it. And I think I just saw the delay plugin. I think it's called like Replica or something like that. One of these primal, that Sound Toys, Patcher, Pan Man, whatever. Radiator, Sound Toys. So under dynamics, let me see if they have a limiter mode. Let's just go to presets. This looks more like a straight on compressor, but where's the ratio? We can go infinite to one, which is technically a limiter. Using this as a limiter is a little awkward, so I'm just going to leave it as is. I don't see any peaking. So I want infinite to one. I want my output at 0 dB here. So I'm not clipping. If you want more gain, you just turn up your dry. But technically, this is something else. Let me see if I turn this up. Does it go above the output? So watch your earphones, head speakers, whatever. It goes above the output, which is weird. Okay. Weird thing is there's no ceiling that I can see. We have infinite to one ratio, but I don't see a ceiling that we can set. So this probably isn't built to be a limiter, but whatever. Just warning you that you don't copy my moves and think this is all you have to do. I will say they have one plugin which is really good for drums. We don't need it in this case, but if you wanted to make your drums more snappy, it's a plugin called Transient Master, which is good. I do like this plugin from time to time. And you can pull up your attack. This is good for like samples or just adding sharpness to your kick drum and your snare. I'll add a little bit. but I can't find what I'm looking for. A limiter, an imager plugin, not sure what they would be. I know Reactor 5 is another great effects plugin. It comes with some plugins you can download right inside the plugin, which is pretty decent. Like VHS effects and different things. I want to see those bars in the comments. Turn off my mic and let it play. I just thought of something cool to do with that synth, which is like a... It may or may not work. Let me see it in context. I forgot we're playing pop mono, so it doesn't sound right. I'm not going to use any native stuff. Let's actually use their EQ. So what I'm going to do is take out some of the muddiness, so to speak. Not muddiness, but the warmth of the EP, just so the bass can have more shine. Let's open up a passive EQ and go to mid-side mode. And I want to solo the mono so I can hear how much bass is there. And then solo the stereo, see how much bass is there. And trying to see. Sounds like it's mostly centered. Now, a lot of the bass is in the stereo, so I'm going to unlink all these, the purple thing, and let's cut, switch this to cut mode. Where's our cut modes? Switch this a little light to cut, and cut somewhere around using a pretty decent bell, 100, 300 hertz, probably in the 200s. Take out some of that like warmth, because it's fighting against the bass line. Let's go to stereo, do the same thing. It's a lot of cutting, but it's because it's fighting against something else. Also, the guitar. Do the same exact thing here, passive EQ, or you could use the, oh, what was it? I forgot the EQ name that quick. Solid EQ. And we can use, where's the filter? I'm looking for a high pass, low pass filter. It looks more, here we go, high pass filter. Cut some of that low end out under like 150, so it doesn't conflict with the bass. Thank you. right? So if you want these project files, just click that link below. I'll give these away for free. Thanks for watching. If you like this series and want to get into specific contact libraries, let me know in the comments below. Please like the video so we can like keep this going. Also, what was I going to say? Specific libraries, specific stuff from native instruments themselves. Again, remember, I'm working on the older version, not the newer stuff, but let me know in the comments below what you want to see. And thanks for watching. It's BusyWorksBeats.com. You get these free project files below. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.